Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mr. TARDIS, and I am aware that I'm a couple of hours late. That's what you get when you finish work at 7 p.m. and this trailer drops around 3 or 4 o'clock. So I'm finally home from work, I'm all settled, ready to watch and react to this trailer. This is Doctor Who Series 11 Trailer 2. Let's go! Oh, it's one of those. There's a little pre-thing. Okay. That looks pretty good, effects-wise. Oh.
I'm the doctor. When people need help, I never refuse.
What do we do?
Why are you asking her?
Because she's in charge, bro.
Says who?
Says us.
Let's get a shift on.
Lot of explosions.
I'm just a traveler.
Whoa. It actually looks like a Star Trek space station.
Do what I can.
That looks so good. Who YouTube channel? They have a subscription thing. Whoa, that looks so good. Okay, initial thoughts, just the cinematography, the special effects, like just that opening shot with the space station here, that looks like something out of Firefly. And I know, like, in terms of visual effects, that's not a huge compliment, because Firefly was like 10-15 years ago, but that was a pretty high budget, high profile American production. For a UK production, That looks like seamless photographic stuff. That's a really good shot. That's a wonderful way to end the trailer as well. Just like seemingly blowing a kiss. I didn't mind the music. Like the music in the Breaking the Glass Ceiling trailer, which the content of the trailer I thought was fine, but the music I could have done without. I'm not gonna like tear the trailer down because of the music, but yeah, it suited much better here. Although I've heard that the Australian version of this trailer, which is apparently identical, I've not seen it. I've only just seen this one. Apparently, the Australian version has actual instrumental music, which apparently goes better, but who knows. But yeah, the TARDIS team look really cool. There's Bradley Walsh. I like the weird, dorky, geeky expressions. Jodie Whittaker, we've seen the images of her on Doctor Who magazine and in these trailers. She's ridiculously photogenic, and I'm not trying to say that in like a shallow way. She just looks, she has a great presence on screen, and she emits a real personality. This space station looks really cool. It looks like, kind of what it's like UK versions of like Star Trek, where they try and pay homage to that. It actually does look like it's pulling it off successfully. But one thing I love about this trailer, which previous ones did not quite do for me, and it kind of makes sense, this is closer to the actual release, this is closer to the broadcast, is that we actually are getting kind of a sense of the feel of the show. It feels fun, it feels vibrant, it feels like the Doctor is going to be this heroic figure and the companions are going to be along for this great fun ride, and that the cinematography is great. We've got a few scary, spooky, atmospheric moments, like tossing coat looking underneath the table and there's a weird tentacle thing. Bradley Walsh's run is terrific, kicking a bag. I guess I love some of these shots. Like I said, Jodie Whittaker just looks terrific on camera. It's about time. Is a pretty cool multi-layered tagline. This trailer really did it for me. I really dug it. The pop music feels very appropriate as well, in this longer context with like all of the images around it as well. I dug the hell out of this thing. Is that a giant spider behind them chasing them? Yeah, giant spider. Giant spider monsters, everybody, confirmed. You heard it here first. Yeah, this trailer, yeah, this really did it for me, this one. Like, I'm not going to say harsh, because I've seen harsh criticism of previous marketing for this series before. Most of it unwarranted, but some of it with like legitimate credence. This trailer really did it for me. But what about you folks? What did you think of this second trailer, this one that is much closer to the release of Series 11? And I shall see you folks next time.